Today we're looking at the Internationalization API for JavaScript. We're going to be using Node, and we're also going to be looking specifically at Relative Time Format. This is a really cool API, because this is actually built into JavaScript. It's not in every browser yet, but we can use it on a few desktop browsers and a few mobile browsers as well. What we're going to be doing is using Node.js, so specifically version 12 onwards has support for the Internationalization API. One of the benefits of using Node.js instead of relying on the browser compatibility is that if you needed to support Edge or Internet Explorer and your server is in Node, well then you can just upgrade your version of Node and use the Internationalization API. And this doesn't actually require any additional libraries. There is one thing that may trip you up, however. Node doesn't actually include the API by default because it's a bunch of additional languages, so by default it's just going to come with English. So let's try and use it. So if we open up Node, we're using Node version 12.13.1, and we can use Intl, which is the internationalization library. However, if we try and do something useful with it, you'll notice we're going to get some kind of weird results if we're not using English. So we'll start off with an English example, and we want to see what one day ago is. Right, so that seems to work. Now if we do the same thing, we'll copy and paste this one here, but we're going to change the language from English to, let's say, French. And now if we attempt to do this again, it just says one day ago, which is incorrect. That is not French. So how do we fix this? Well, one thing we can do is download a library. I said before that in order to use the Internationalization API that you don't actually need to download a library. So that is the case if you want to build Node from source. But that's a kind of a pain because it means you have to use a custom version of Node, you have to install that on your environment, on your production server. Instead, we're going to use an npm module, full ICU. And all this does is installs the data files which you would usually get by compiling Node with all the data files, all the language data files. But instead, this is a nice convenient way to add it. It means that you don't have to touch your version of Node and it's just gonna work out of the box. This is pretty easy to install. We run npm install, and if we come over here and have a look at our package, instead of just running our app, we want to specify the ICU data directory, which in this case is in the Node modules. Once we do that, we'll be able to use the API as intended. So let's jump over to app and take a look. So what is relative time format? Well, it's a kind of thing you might see on posts if you're trying to make a time or a relative time more human readable. So instead of saying one day ago or this happened on the 26th of January, you could say this happened yesterday. This was updated a week ago, something like that. It's approximate, but it's more human readable. Let's see how this works with days. So we've got our language set to English. We have our locale matcher set to lookup, which means if the language isn't found, this string here, then it's going to default back to whatever the system language is or whatever the language is set to in Node. In my case, this will be English. The numeric key is set to auto, which means we can have more human readable messages like yesterday. But you could set this to numeric always, which will say one day ago, rather than using yesterday or next week, last week, things like that. And the style is set to long. So we have long, short, and narrow. Sometimes short and narrow will be the same thing, but that really changes between if you want to say month or if you want to abbreviate that to MO dot. So let's have a look at days. You can see we are grouping this just for the a nicer output format. We've specified our relative time format, and we want to format the day minus one day, plus one day, and plus 2 days. So we expect this to be yesterday, tomorrow, and in 2 days. So let's have a look at this. Run npm start, and we can see yesterday, tomorrow, in 2 days. That's exactly what we expect. But because we're using the internationalization framework, we can type an FR for French, as we did before. And now when we run it, we're going to get the relative time in French. Here you can see it's translated for yesterday, tomorrow, and in 2 days. So that's all very well, but we can also do weeks, and we can also do months. And the API is super easy to use. We just specify in the format what the offset is, either positive or negative, and we give it some unit, day, week, month, year. So what languages do we actually have available? Well, if we have a look at the Intl relative time format and we scroll down a bit, you can see the locales are listed here. And it's a BCP47 language tag. So if we click here, international page, scroll down a bit more, and we can see the various tags here in the IANA language subtag registry. And we have a huge long list of languages. Now, the internationalization API may not have all of these languages. That depends on what Unicode characters are available for the font you're using. And it's also dependent on if it's just supported in the data or not. So that's going to depend on what version of the ICU we're using and whether our work has been put into that language to actually translate everything. So as you can see, we have hundreds and hundreds of languages here. So let's test them out. At the moment we're using French, but how about Arabic? There we go. Or we can try Japanese, Chinese, Afrikaans. So we can switch the language just by using the two-letter code. But there are also specific localities within certain countries or regions which are going to change the way that it's going to format. Let's take a look at Chinese, for example. So here we're just using ZH, but we can also make this more specific. Let's have a look at Cantonese. So that's ZH, YUE. And here we go. If we compare them, see the translation is different depending on if we are using Chinese for mainland China or Cantonese, which for the Hong Kong region. So that's a quick look at the internationalization API, specifically the relative time format. You can use this to get a human readable time format and translate it into the languages that you need to support. Until next time.